Mazdog 7. Yo, what up? This is my new Arsenal career mode. I go for Arsenal, and I think they're an amazing club. And if you're wondering why Cech was in the goalkeeper position there, because we just signed him yesterday, and that is very exciting as we get a world-class keeper. But I won't babble on too much about that. Now, this is our Champions League group. We've got Shakhtar, CSKA, and Feyenoord. The reason why I didn't do the actual proper groups that we had, because I'm sick of playing Dortmund all the time. Just annoying. And the reason why I picked Djibouti is an inside joke with one of my friends. So here we are. Now in the office, they want us to reach the final, the scouts, and then we have Alexis Sanchez. Yeah, the more career modes you do, the more like they just give you injuries at the start. And then we're looking at the scout report they've provided us with. We've got Benteke there. I'll add him to the shortlist, as well as Berahino, because he's always good. That's about it from that. I don't think there's anyone else worth looking at, even though Touré would be good. And here we are, Sanchez has some beautiful stats, and he will be a key player in our team. And he's also got some nice traits. Then we have Giroud. Giroud. He'll be like our third choice player, because I'm looking to bring in another striker. So he'll probably be our Capital One Cup striker. He won't get too much game time, and we'll probably sell him next season. And here we have Walcott, who's gonna be our first right mid, and he will interchange with the Ox. Here we have Ozil, some beautiful stats, one of my favorite players in the game, in Ultimate Team, he's very good. And then 4-star skill moves, not that I'm very good at skills. And then we have Cockerlin, finally, he's actually a CDM. He's been such a revelation for Arsenal this season. What a legend. I'll also be looking to bring in another CDM and maybe a backup cam, so the midfield will be pretty congested. And here we have Santi Cazorla. And then here's Gibbs. He'll be a good left back, so we'll use him. And then we have Koscielny, the beast that he is, bloody legend. His age is a bit old, so in January and next season we'll be looking at getting another centre back in, maybe like Varane or someone like that. And then here we have Bellerin. Now my signings, I'm trying to be as realistic as possible. That's why I've got players that have been linked with Arsenal, which we'll see later. And there's Cech, of course. And then we have Welbeck. Wilshere would swap for Cazorla. Ramsey would swap in for Coquelin. And then we have Chamberlain. And then we have Monreal. Gabriel would swap him for Mertesacker. He's a good defender, Gabriel is. And then we have Szczesny. Now, I'm considering whether to sell Ospina or Szczesny, because I've got like 6 goalkeepers. And there we go, just looking through the team. And then that's that, pretty much. Yeah. And then this is my shortlist. We have Kurt Zouma, so we're going to inquire about all these players. And then we have Jeffrey Kondogbia. And then we have Morgan Schneiderlin. He's a realistic player, and so is Kondogbia, even though Kondogbia's now gone to Inter Milan, which is a shame. Arsenal could have bought him. And then we have Sissoko, who was linked in January. Benteke, because he's a beast. Berahino, because he's English, I guess. And then we have Higuain, who's been linked in the past. Aubameyang that's been recently leaked. And if I had Aubameyang, I would have Sanchez, Aubameyang and Walcott, the paciest three in the Premier League, probably in the world. Like in real life and in FIFA. Be really cool. And then we have Dermot as well. And then they want 45 million for Vidal, 14 million for Sissoko, 11 for Berahino, 52 million for Higuain. So just see what else comes back. Kondogbia 10.5. I'm gonna go in there, offer them 6.5. And then Southampton want 21 million for Schneiderlin. And then we have Aubameyang. I'm gonna offer 15.5 million for him. And then Zouma, they won't let him. And then we have Schneiderlin here. And then, sorry, but the cat's just got herself stuck again. There, good girl. And then 7 million for Sissoko. And then we'll advance further. Then we have a transfer offer for Flamini, and I'm just gonna sell him straight up. And we're going to go through players that we want to sell. And we have Arteta. We're going to add him to the transfer list. As well as, well, Flamini. As well as Diaby. And Rositsky. And then players like Hayden, we're gonna put out on loan. I'm gonna loan out all our youngsters. Yep, this Iliev guy. I've heard of him before, but didn't really know he was actually playing for Arsenal and FIFA as well. And then Zalala is one of my favorite young players because he just grows and grows and grows. He's a ledge. Season long loan for, I can't say his name. And then we have more. We want more of that more. No, actually, don't even bother listening to that. And then we have Bielik, who we got in January. And I was contemplating whether to sell Szczesny or not. Szczesny or Ospina, but Szczesny is younger than Ospina. And then that's that practically. And then we'll just advance. And then final scout report on Schneiderlin. It's got some decent stats. Whoops, clicked on Berahino. And he is 81 overall. And then they rejected the offer, so I don't think I'm gonna pursue him. Because I can get Kondogbia, he's a lot cheaper. And then we have Joseph Dermot. Should just don't think I'm gonna bother signing him. He doesn't look all that good. And then Newcastle won 10.5 and Monaco won 8.5, but I'm gonna be stingy. I'm gonna offer them 7.5 million. So if that's a 500,000, and then we offer them 9 million for Sissoko, see what they say to that. If we could get him for 9 million, I'll be very pleased with that. And then Dortmund want 19.5 million for Aubameyang, and we're just going to offer them straight up because he's quality. He is so good in Ultimate Team. And I am not a pace person. Well, I sort of am. But don't go accusing me of being a pace person, because hopefully in FIFA 16 pace won't be as OP as it is in 15, especially when people have that team this season, Lacazette and that inform Walcott. They just like run around you, it's so annoying. But I'll save that rant. And then there's this youngster, which I was just looking at out of pure curiosity. And then we sold someone, I think that was Rosicky. And then we're offering up the contracts for Sissoko because they've accepted the offer. Yeah, it was Rosicky. And then we have the offer accepted from Dortmund, and we're going to offer them 5 years. Important first team player, because we also want to give that guy Wolves a go. How awesome was that goal against Manchester United? And then we'll just offer them 8 million for Kondogbia. And that should wrap up the episode today. Thanks for watching, guys. Please comment, rate, and subscribe.